आई थिंक इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट टू रियलाइज दैट धर्मपाल जी वॉज नॉट अ ट्रेंड हिस्टोरियन और अ ट्रेंड फिलोसफर इन द सेंस ही यू नो लेफ्ट हिज स्टडीज मिड वे एंड ही वॉज डूइंग बी एस सी इन लाहौर एंड आफ्टर दैट ही डिडंट डू एनी फॉर्मल स्टडीज ही लेफ्ट इट इन 1942 ड्यूरिंग द क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट. So he was a self-taught man, and I believe his research started. There were two important things which prompted him to get into this research. One was his observation while doing some kind of a work on the Indian panchayati system, and he went to Rajasthan to study the panchayati system, the newly formed panchayati system. And when he was talking to the villagers over there, he realized that there was a Sarkari panchayati body, but there was a traditional panchayati body, of which he was not even aware of. And then that led him to discover that the traditional panchayat was very powerful and used to take decisions in a different way. And that was the one which was really it had a certain manyata in the community. So that was quite shocking to him. And then another incident happened when he was reading Mahatma Gandhi, and he came to know what he said in 1931 in Chatham House in London, when he went there for the second roundtable conference. And there Mahatma Gandhi said that India was far more educated 100 years ago than it is today. And the British dug at our beautiful tree and left the roots exposed, etc., etc. And there was a big hoo-ha about it in the British press. And they said that Gandhi is talking nonsense, that kind of a thing. And then one admirer of Gandhi wrote to him, saying that how could you say make such an irresponsible statement. And Gandhi said that I just wrote him a small thing on a postcard saying that look into your own records to verify what I've said. So these two things led Dharampal to delve into the records of the Britishers in the India Office Library, mainly in London. And that from one thing led to another, to another, to another. And we are, most of us are aware of his great research work in the field of education, science and technology, Indian civil disobedience, traditions of civil disobedience, etc., etc. I'm not going to get into that. But I believe, this is my understanding, and I think a lot of us believe who've been close to Dharampal or who have studied him, that his research work is one, and it's extremely important. But what is perhaps even more important is how it impacted his own perception, the way he started looking at India, and more importantly, the ordinary Indian people, how Indian mind works. Because this was a question which always stayed with him, that what is it in the Indian mind which looks very simple or looks a little chaotic or looks, not up to the mark according to the modern standards. And yet he had to marvel at the ingenuity of the Indian people. And he always felt that there was a misalignment between the way Indian people work, the way Indian people think, the way they behave, and the modern system in which they are forced to lead their lives. The modern nation state, the modern system, there is a complete dissonance between the way the system works and the way the Indian is. The so-called uneducated, illiterate, the ordinary Indian. Well, we will not get into the educated Indian mind, because that is, even Mahatma Gandhi has commented a lot on that. So I think Bhartiya Chitmanas Kal was a culmination of, in a way, of his understanding, which got developed slowly while he was doing his research. And coupled with that research, his own observation, because I think I've met very few people who have such a keen eye, keen sense, that sensitivity and that penetrating vision to get behind what is visible, to see what is lying under the surface. He had that kind of observation power. So Bhartiya Chitmanas Kal is basically trying to tell us that, look, it's also a bit speculative, because Dharampal ji always believed in he used to talk a lot about the speculative mind, that we have to, when we don't have data, we don't have hard facts, we need to be a little speculative in our thinking. We need to connect the dots and use a bit of our imagination too. So Bhartiya Chitmanas Kal is something like that he is trying to understand what India is. How do Indians look at time, for instance? We don't look at time in a linear fashion. You know, for us, you know, yesterday and tomorrow, we give the same name, Kal, for yesterday, and Kal for tomorrow. We give for day before, Parso, and we also say day after, Parso. So these are not just mere accidents or ignorance. There must be something else behind this, that we have been looking at time in a cyclical manner. You know, even the concept of Chaturyuga, you know, Kalyug to Dwapar and Treta and Satyug, and then again going back, you know, the cyclical way of looking at time is very unique to India. Even our the way we talk, I this is my personal experience, which I relate to Bhartiya Chitmanas Kal and Dharampal, is, you know, we don't talk in a transactional manner. Who are you? And I give you one answer. You know, this interview style, which has become very very common these days, especially with the media and the TV, you know, they want a 2-minute answer to everything. So, you know, there's one question and one response, one question and one response. And many times the response has to be in yes or no, right or wrong. And that is such a, it's almost violent, that way of talking. Indian way of talking is more in a storytelling form, in a circuitous form. You relate things, you associate things, one thing you associate with another. And many times what you want to say, you say through examples, through an incident which has happened in the past. I mean, many of the stories from Mahabharata and Ramayana and various Purans are almost eternal, in the sense that the meaning that they convey can be applicable to many, many situations which are happening even today, because they carry behind the surface the archetypes are, they never go. So Indians have a very different way of talking, of conveying, of communicating, of thinking and doing things. And I think that is what Bhartiya Chitmanas Kal is all about. We need to understand that when the Europeans came here in the beginning, in the 16th century, 17th century, irrespective of how rich or poor the person is, wearing the same kind of clothes up there, you know, on the upper part of their body. They are not wearing any slippers or shoes, not that they were not available. but they wouldn't wear them, and they wouldn't wear anything on top. So they felt that this is an indication of poverty. And yet they knew that it is a very rich nation, it is a very rich country, and these people are not poor. So they couldn't correlate these two things. And you know, this has troubled them all along, from those times to, I would say, to present times, that they don't understand India at one level. At another level, they feel there is something here which we don't understand, and yet, you know, they see it in the result, in the way things happen here. So I think what the Europeans were never able to understand, Dharampal has tried in a speculative manner to show that this is how India is. When he's saying India, he's talking of an ordinary Indian mind, because for him, he used to keep the ordinary Indian on a very high pedestal. Let me tell you that. So, you know, this is my understanding of Dharampal's Bharatiya Chitmanas Kala.